Good morning. I am in Sevilla and I'm very sleepy because I actually slept on a bus and then I got woken up by bus arriving in Sevilla. Let me sleep. Now I will, I don't know. Now I'm just going and I don't know where because I still haven't woken up. But I think I will go to the hostel, sit a little bit, like 15 minutes, and then go think where I can watch the sunrise. I decided to go already to my sunrise viewing point because it got light already. But I guess the sun will go here and I will see everything. But I guess it's okay. Look what I have for this beautiful moment. So obviously I'm tired and I was waiting in hostel for someone to come for like 2 hours. Then someone came, but my bed was still not ready to check in. So they gave me a hammock and now I'm searching for a park to put it up and just chill. So nice. I have no idea if I will be able to do it though because I've never done it, but let's see. Okay, I think I did it, but let's try and fit in. I'm so happy. I didn't think I would do it. Oh my god. I will buy a hammock now. It's so cool. You can just bring it anywhere and just lay. I'm now going to grab food and it's 38 degrees in shadow and I think I've never experienced such heat and it is intense.
What better to eat than cold gazpacho on a hot day?
One thing that nobody really mentions about traveling is that it's tiring and it's okay to take a rest because you might need the energy during the night. Because one thing about traveling alone is that you can meet so many new people and get to know everyone, and here I spent the evening with people from hostel and it was very, very fun. And yeah,
good morning. So I actually wanted to go to Cadiz today and because I want beach and I love beach, I love swimming and it's too hot here. But the bus was 17 euros one way and I wanted to go with BlaBlaCar, but it was too confusing because whatever. So I decided to not go. And yesterday I met some people who are going to Cadiz today and we became friends. And I'm going with them today, and I'm so excited, and it's gonna be fun.
I'm closing my eyes, bro. It's crazy.
Drinking away another miserable day on the job.
esta ambición desmedida por las mujeres, la pasta y los focos. Me está quitando la vida, muy poquito a poquito a poco. Me pregunta la prensa, Puchito, ¿cuál es la maña? Sin cantar ni afinar, pa' que me escuche tu España.
Hello, this is my last day in Sevilla and I'm in I'm in Alcazar, just sitting in the garden, and it's very, very beautiful and very, very hot. Here's the water fountain, and that's everything that I need.
Ahora quiero triunfar y ganar y salir en la tele y la radio. Es un veneno cruel y violento que estáis alimentando, que va a hacer que me mate mientras todos seguís ahí mirando.
Lo hice por ti.
¿Cómo no?
Lo hice por ti.
Eso.
Lo hice por ti.
Por ti nada más, por ti.
Lo hice por ti.
Para que me mires.
Lo hice por ti.
I was sitting here for like an hour and just watching this flamenco show, and it was one of the best experiences in Sevilla because it was so unique and something that I've never seen before, and they were so passionate, and just look at it yourself, and I hope you feel the atmosphere just a little bit.
Calma, tranquilo, lo pierde. Tiene tan verde mirar. Calma, tranquilo, lo pierde. Voy a sacarla a bailar. Por si bailando me olvido. Por si bailando me olvido. De la que me gusta a mí. No quiere bailar conmigo. Bailándolo.
Flamenco shows so much, and it just makes me feel like I'm really in Spain, and I think I've never felt more in Spain like in here. Got interrupted by horse. But really, I love this city, but it's just so hot that it's, I don't know, I would enjoy it more if it wouldn't be so hot. But it's still very, very nice, and I just feel so much culture just walking around, and yeah, makes me love whole Spain being here.
Thank you.
had a beach day, the water is amazing, and now I'm waiting to dry off, and then I'm going to get some food. I'm probably just gonna come back to the beach because I really missed it in Sevilla. In this hot weather, I can't without water. Today is actually the last full day of this trip, and I'm a bit sad because it was so amazing and I didn't expect for it to be this great. It was my first trip alone, but it went by so fast, and I will definitely do this again. This was such a great experience. I met so many cool people. This was the best decision to go here alone, and I'm very happy and very sad that it's over. This is my last hostel, and it's super nice, and I'm alone, and I have a private bathroom. I'm so happy, and a cute little window, and that's all I need for my last night. Ready to go. I am back in Madrid. I didn't expect to be this sad, and I just had the best time ever, and I knew that I will like traveling alone and that it will be amazing. So somebody was walking by, so I had to end, but I didn't expect to have this great time. And I don't even know if in videos it's visible that I had such a great time, because of course I didn't film each person that I met and each conversation that I had, obviously, but I met so many great people and I heard so many stories, and I'm just so happy that I did it, but I'm so sad that it's over. Also, now I feel like I love Spain so much after this trip. Before that I didn't feel like that, and I was feeling a little bit bad that I don't feel like that, because everybody likes it and why I don't love it. But now I just saw so much culture. And I felt how nice people are, and I can't wait to learn Spanish because I want to feel it even more, because I want to be able to have conversations with these nice people, and I will definitely learn Spanish, but probably when I'm not in Spain anymore. But I am just very grateful that I had the chance to go on this trip and that I did it, and maybe for some it's a huge step to travel alone for 2 weeks, or maybe for some it's nothing, but for me I was somewhere in the middle. I was stressing for one day before going, and I was stressing mostly about the transportation, if I will be able to find buses and stuff like that, but I didn't have any problems, and it just proves that all this just happens in your head. And yeah, and staying in hostels was the best idea ever. I can't wait to do this again, and I encourage you, if you ever had a idea to go on a solo trip, do it, it's the best. I believe it's not for everyone, but I think everyone should try it. And this is how my last evening in Madrid looks like. Very pretty, very beautiful. Bye bye. With that note, I will end this video, and thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you felt a little bit of my happiness, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.